Good morning. This is Doc Stout with Battered Arena. If you tuned in yesterday, you saw that I finally drafted a deck that I was pretty happy with and managed to scrape out a win, despite the fact that it seems like this deck has almost no win conditions. So I guess I would call this Frost Mage Control. I do have a few creatures in here, but considering how much removal you usually find in a game of arenas, not nearly enough. So my win was as my opponent gave up as he was about to run out of cards and start dealing himself damage. Let's see if we can't find our next competitor. I played a lot of Mage, but usually I've played the more aggressive style that has plus spell damage and a few fireballs or maybe a pyroblast. What I would call a fire mage. Not this Frost Mage control, like, stop your guys from attacking and blow them up style.
Alright. Gina versus Uther.
So we've got a paladin.
I will fight with honor.
You asked for it.
Looks like we've got some taunters, mid-game play, kind of like questing adventure in my starting hand. We'll just throw back the Fen Creeper and hope to see him later. Sunwalker. It's like the same thing, only a little worse. Yeah, that's fine. My turn one plays... Ooh, it seemed pretty obvious, but I don't think it is. I'm going to have to play the Mana Worm because my two taunters, I will actually bump him. That would have been a major mistake. He has no play on turn one, which means I get away with something. In stark contrast to yesterday's game, it looks like at the moment I am the aggressor. I think almost no matter what he does, I play a questing adventure next turn. I suppose there could be cards that must be answered that I could deal one damage to with Fire Blast, but I can't imagine what they'd be. I mean, that's fine. Yep, there's the Fen Creeper again.
Give me a quest.
Yeah, I guess I just swing in for more damage. Cone of Cold is likely to get me some value here. Yeah. Cone of Cold, those guys?
I don't have enough mana.
That's fine, because I can Frostbolt there and then Firebolt him.
Quest accepted.
Yeah, much more aggressive start this time. Even if he has some sort of swing back, I think I'm in pretty good shape with my two taunters. Ooh! That was actually a pretty nice play. It's not going to do anything, but it was a pretty nice play. You got a way to heal him, buddy? If you do, I'm going to have to lose a guy.
Not on my watch.
I see. Divine Shield. That is a way to deal with him. Frostbolt. I guess I will play a Haunted Creeper in this situation since I can no longer just kill him. And get in for a lot of pressure. Now, I have a few things to worry about here.
I can taste the mana.
Alright, he's trying to get value off of his knife juggler. I don't blame him. Maybe even hit me and gain some life with the True Silver Champion. I do have an answer to weapons, but not in my hand. So what are we gonna do? Yeah, he can't let that thing stick around. I would react in exactly the same way. Alright, our play here seems pretty obvious. Now I've got a taunt shield up. He can take it out, but not without great expense. He'll have to use his last swing with his weapon. Take a little bit more damage. I wish I knew what was in his hand.
For the Lich King!
That's pretty good. Still not enough to finish the Fen Creeper off, though. That's fine. Alright, so we deal a damage here. We wish we could afford the Reckless Rocketeer at the moment, but we'll play the Stranglethorn Tiger. So won't be able to be targeted. If he has a board wipe, I really need to do this now. He can't target him to heal him, so I could guarantee that the Spectral Knight dies. Which I think puts me in a position, unless he can heal now or play a taunt, that where I win.
Reporting for duty.
He can't heal if he can't play a taunter. Yeah, actually, that's another quick win for this deck. A much different style of win than we saw in yesterday's game, where I had to grind out slowly. This time, there are actually win conditions, and it is possible to be aggressive with this deck. Two wins. So far, undefeated. This is unprecedented for all the episodes. Actually, so was one win, but... Let's see. Let me check our time here. If you've just joined me, this is Doxed Out with Battered Arena. I am not in the chat at the moment. I don't have the laptop set up this morning. Let's go for another game. Very happy with this deck. I think that I need to learn some of the other hero powers and the decks that they can build that are not constructed. But... Mage has actually treated me fairly well. I started outside my comfort zone, but we're kind of landing back inside it.
Jaina versus Gul'dan.
Gul'dan.
Your soul,
my old friend.
You asked for it.
All these cards seem good, but not all of them seem good at the beginning. Huh. I mean, there's a lot worse cards in the deck, though. Yeah, I'm going to see how this hand works. My instinct was to throw something away, but I can't imagine what. I would have liked to have some removal. Without the pressure on, though, I think I'm just going to keep my coin. Don't fear the Bloodfin Raptor. That's a pretty good draw. Hopefully we'll get him to overextend into being able to kill a few things, though. Especially one... Oh, boy, that thing's pretty good. Questing Adventure. I normally love to play Questing Adventure in this situation, but I think he just dies. So, Injured Blade Master. And get in for some damage. I'm going to take a lot of damage myself, but that's fine. He can kill... Or you get a Shadow Bolted to death, that's fine. Getting pretty close to having to use my Cone of Cold. Actually, let's just frost bolt. And then finish it off to draw a card. That's good for later game. I'm getting pretty close to wanting to play Mirror Entity to see what his big play is. Yeah, I don't want to copy any of those. We'll pop the shield. All these guys die to Flame Strike. I think I may have to take some more damage, though. Next turn, I can Flame Strike. Reserve my Cone of Cold in case I survive. A four casting cost creature. Ugh, that's not what I wanted. That's fine, it saved me a little bit of damage, and I can hit him for the blowout now. Yes, overextend my pretty. Alright, I don't even have to think about this one. I get the extra, and kaboom. 5 for 1. 5 for 2. Now we can safely build up behind the loving embrace of the Fen... Fen Creeper. Be nice to silence this guy. I'm at 11. Yeah, let's
give me a quest.
Get some pressure on. Then I can play the Taunter. Yeah, so different from yesterday. Okay, that's fair. Let's see, I can play my Taunter. Can Cone of Cold, I guess. See what he gets. Oh, that's terrible. I feel bad about my decisions.
Me?
Alright, still 14 to 11. Yikes. That card is really good.
My eyes are open.
Now I'm really losing. I think I have to Frostbolt. And Flame Strike. And then push for as much damage as I've got. I've still got a couple of tricks up my sleeve, and he's running out of cards, though he can buy them with life, because he healed enough. Oh, God. Yeah, that thing's pretty good. Frostbolt for that thing. Water Elemental... whittle down its life a little bit. Still haven't seen my polymorph. I've still got some real nice plays. Potentially. 9. 6, 7, 8. That's a pretty good play. We'll freeze them both so I don't die. play him, and then everything else goes to his face. That means, I think, that unless he can kill me with one of these two cards, I actually win again. Wow. If I keep having a run like this, I'm going to have to change the name of the series from Bad at Arena to Pretty Okay at Arena, so long as I'm playing Mage. Alright, so I think that I will be continuing this run tomorrow. Very happy. Join me tomorrow to see if I can't cruise towards maybe my best lifetime finish. I think the best arena key I've ever gotten is on 5 or 6 wins, and we're already on 3. So, yeah, I think this deck is much better than I thought it was when I put it together. Maybe I've gotten lucky, but we saw very different styles from the first game yesterday being much more control-y to the first game today being aggro. And this last game kind of almost feeling a little mid-range where I play a few threats, destroy his, and then swing back with much bigger stuff of my own. So, until tomorrow, thanks for tuning in. This is Doc Stout with Bad at Arena.